It's Boys Zappa, King of the Giant Robots, and welcome back to Super Robot Wars X.
Oh,
not GC. Wherein previously, we did the stage. Minefields occurred. The Zaral Empire is on its last legs and its last commanders. Although there's still many a stage left. We are weeding them out one by one. However, today we have an interlude, yet another sub scenario. So let's go shoot some robots. Age 52. Hiki no rei no tapasuru. Break through the enemy lines? I don't know, I feel like that's not translated right. Yeah, enemy breakthrough. Not Chinese. Oh, that's right, it doesn't want to translate. I think that's what I did. Is the way it's written is funky. So what I did was I took the translation, the general translation, which is, or let's try enemy breakthrough. We're doing science tech now. We're gonna switch. Okay. Yeah, so I took the weird character translation and that came to enemy breakthrough or breakthrough enemy lines. And then I took that phrase in English, break through enemy lines, and put that through Japanese, and that's how we got the title. So probably there's a more appropriate translation, but I don't know. Google tries to default to Chinese, and that's not right. These are the mysteries. And I think when I hold... Well, let's see what my phone will do. No, I don't want to translate from Chinese. That's the thing. Hikijin Topa? Heki Jin Topa is what the audio says. Okay. Alright, I'll fucking take it. Heki Jin Topa, maybe. I don't know. Break through the enemy line is the English title. Let's go! The kids are doing a chat. Don't know why. Again, differences in games. The mysteries. Right, I do have a site that could get me here. I mean, it's not best, but it's something. The base cafeteria. The kids are asking about a break. They're getting tired of training. They're worried about the next battle, so they're going to go make adjustments to... The kids are all talking about getting ready for the battles. But also, Barry is one of their teachers. And now they're flirting about talking up Fairy. While talking about classes. And one of the other girls is having to take position of teacher, and they're all upset that Fairy's not coming. Okay, and here Akemi is asking Fairy why Sieg and Sally seem to hate the Zarl so much. Fairy explains that it's because during the final invasion with the Intergalactic Alliance invaded Gardasword, which led to Gardasword being destroyed, they were at the forefront, so they were forced to see their comrades die and their planet destroyed, and the main attacking force of the Intergalactic Alliance was the Zarl. Akemi asks if Fairy also hates the Zarl, but she says that she doesn't like them, but she's wondering if their invasion really did lead to Gardasword's being destroyed, as it was publicly announced. So, allegedly. Hulruka's announcement that the Zeon experimentation area was attacked by Zarl forces, leading to the Zeon going out of control, which led to the planet blowing up, seems a bit fishy. She wasn't on the home planet at the time, but she feels like it was orchestrated by someone else. Akemi asks if she thinks it's Hulruka's work, but what does he gain by blowing up his own planet? Fairy doesn't know, since it's all just speculation. However, no more talk, no more speculation. It's time for fighting. We need to break through. No longer we need to take our weaker units. Foster Diger again. Oxygar as well. Okay, because usually I was sending Sazabi and that new guy. We don't need to send the Grim Kaiser, and we don't need to send you're not serving a function anymore. Hayato, alright, that's why the numbers. There's Char or destroy them all and get to the designated point. Gone. Oh, man. I'm gonna test something. Thank you. Oh no, we've reduced their number. Reinforcements have appeared. Right, the test is... resupply. And movement. Yes! Excellent. Because I gave Simone here one of my hidden aways that was on someone who... Oh no, it was the one I just picked up. That someone ended up with... No. I was just thinking of who would benefit from having it. Couldn't think of who. Dang old Bragger, you're all the way up there. Max! Damn asteroid field. another round of going fast. Monsoon power! Right, I need to give you hidden away soon. I think eventually Hayato might catch the bench. Nice. Thank you. Yeah, I don't watch any animations in a minute. Yeah. Gotta do that. Content. Turn. Get it straight. What if I cheat the Ow! Stop it. Crunch. Wait, understanding this correctly, eight or less enemies and enemy reinforcements show up. And will continue to show up for 10 more waves. So if you're really hard up on the, at this point to get some experience and some levels, there's 10 waves here. I think I'll just make my way over. I think the most important part is that the boat gets there.
真剣にやりな。よし、石をつけてお礼するぜ。よし、キッド、目いっぱい近づいてやっから、一撃で叩き切ってくんだまし。任せとけ。イエイ。行くぞ、フライソード。チェックメイト。
Now the question becomes, is it done when boat gets there, or is it done when everyone moves in, because that's a pain in the ass. By 50%. Large, large. Why 50%? Right, I should be moving people. Oh no. Oh no. Alright, now we're getting dangerous. Really? Really? What if? What if? Okay, boat needs to get there. That's the solution. Boat. Alright, and then we're going to do it again, but this time we're just going to go ahead and optimize our destruction. Optimize what we can get. Body parts picked up. Really? Piece of shit, 18.
相手の位置がはっきり見えるわ。うかつよ。見える。あなたには私を倒すことはできないわ。
ここは僕たちに任せてください。
王子、ここは大王者のパワーで
やるしかないね。カクさん、しからばここは大いにやってやろう。ビームフォーガン。
Guts.
Already damaged.
Yes.
からな。
Space. There you go.
たちのすべてを込めるんだ。行くぜ。
Boat out. Like, I ain't got no time for this shit. Done. Oh, there's a whole ass paragraph I didn't read for the start of battle. Duh. But we saw it happen. Enemies appear on Route to Zeon. Bright orders the team to rush through since they can't waste time here. After rushing through, the team resumes their course to Zeon. Ba-da-da. In Sally and Zeke's quarters, Sally's adamant about deploying against Char, but Zeke forbids her to do so. Sally asks why her brother can deploy, but she can't, and he says that Sally's going to let her emotions get the best of her in the coming fight. It's Sanford for him because he's fought alongside the team for a couple of missions now, and he knows how they fight. But Sally would just throw the group's teamwork out the window. I don't like team's teamwork. That's redundant. It's logical, it's correct, but the redundancy makes it painful. The way she would fight emotionally would throw the group's teamwork out the window. Sally's not buying this shit that much, but says as per their agreement with the Kenyan fairy, each of them can cooperate if they want to. So she's going in. Fuck you, bro. Though Sieg says that whatever the reason, he's not letting Sally deploy, and locks the door, telling her ass to stay put until this is over. Damn. And so that is repeatable. Basically, who knows how many times Zarl enemies get in our way along the way. But we don't need to go that far. Thank y'all for watching. Good night, Space Dogs.